Well, good afternoon, everyone. It's about 20 to 6 here in London. I suppose that's about 20 to 1 American Eastern Time. So we've had an up and down session so far. The 3900 level on the S&P seems to be holding. But as you can see, all the measures of the trend on the VectorVest system are down. The primary wave, or the shortest term measure of the trend, is down. Underlying trend is down. And the longest term measure of the trend used by position traders is down. There's an awful lot more companies on a sell than on a buy, about 3 to 1, 4 to 1. If we have a look at this market in a little bit more detail, and I go to the VectorVest composite of the US, that's the VectorVest composite. This recording thing gets in the way. Over the last, 6 months, I can put on our market timing signals here. If I put on the longest term measure of the market, it turned down at Powell's talk week before last. The medium term market timing system, called the DEW, has called this market exceptionally well over the last 6 months. A down signal, an up signal that didn't come to much, and then this up signal, which was really great. And it's saying that the only way to trade this market is down. If I blow this up to a 3 month chart, we can now put on the shortest term measure of the London market, and that's called the primary wave. And I find this very useful for short term spread bets. If my spread bets are in the direction of the primary wave, then they tend to go quite well. And for those of you that are not UK people, a spread bet is essentially a future. And I trade that, apart from the legalese, it's a futures contract on the S&P 500. As you can see, I called this sell-off exceptionally well, and there was money to be made in this. These moves for short-term traders, that was a beauty, wasn't it? And it's saying since the 19th of August, the only way to have traded this market was down. But let's look at the dynamics behind this market at the moment. And where we're sitting at, ladies and gentlemen, in the American market, and where we're sitting at in the UK market, is a very similar and exceptionally important support level. As you can see, there's a line through markets here, support, resistance, now coming onto support again. If we get a close below this level, then that would be, in technical parlance, a closing overlap of this particular wave up. And a couple of closes below that particular close just across there, that would be very, very bearish indeed. The weekly chart is still showing a very, very bearish momentum pattern. I've looked at that on many occasions here, but I think we'll probably get a bounce here. So there's two levels in the market that are important. If we get closes, not just intraday excursions, but closes below that level, then that would be very bearish indeed, and that would indicate that this is a corrective wave. And what happens after a correction? Well, the trend starts to move in its original direction, in the direction of this big wave down. How would that be negated? Well, that would be negated, ladies and gentlemen, by a close above this level. So those are the two main levels to watch on the American markets. And we're very, very close, and I thought we were going to get it at one point this afternoon to closing down around here, which would be a close below 3,900 on the S&P 500. a close above this level would be very, very bullish indeed. But all you need to do is to watch the VectorVest market timing signals. And certainly the signal that I use most is called the DEW. It's a medium-term market timing system, and it will call the market without any great thought at all. But in terms of timing, that's my two very, very important levels. I had a trade this afternoon, and I'll put up, that's the overnight market, and that's a gnarly chart of the overnight market, and all markets for some reason follow a trading plan for weeks on end, and then the trading plan doesn't work. That's just the way it is. You get clusters of good luck and clusters of bad luck. That was a particularly good short there. My method is quite simple. It's based on what Richard Wyckoff taught so many years ago, springs and upthrusts. And I know I'm a bit of a one-track wonder, but that's an upthrust. It broke its way up through that high. The trend was down. If you remember, the primary wave in VectorVest was down. I like to take the trades in the direction of the primary wave on VectorVest. It was down. So the market stuck its nose up there. That was about 10, 11. This is just before the American market opened. I was in fact doing a seminar to VectorVest customers. It was a Tuesday afternoon after our bank holiday, and then it fell like a stone. That was just a great, many people will say that that was a nice flag as well. So it was. There was an upthrust here, but a cheeky little bugger didn't in fact go above those highs, so I only got short underneath that low. But it, every now and then they say the blind pig will discover the corn, so it moved my way. So that's another one. As I say, these methodologies, you get weeks where you make a heap and weeks where they just don't work at all. Clusters of good luck, clusters of bad luck, and it's our job to navigate that and not get downhearted when you have a few losers. That was a good upthrust. I didn't come to as much as that, and that 3900 level, which is that old high that I pointed out way back after the first high after the June low. That's holding this market at the moment. Now today, this happened very early. This is 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock in the UK. But I noted that this was an upthrust, and we got this little, what the candle people call it, tweezer top, I think. For God's sake, don't write in and say I got that wrong, but I think that's what it's called. No, I didn't sell it up there, although if I had testicular fortitude, I would have. But in fact, I sold it underneath that low at 3938, and it fell very nicely indeed. I took off a half. It fell at these lows, just down there at 3904. And then I was called into a meeting, and I had the stop at entry. And then, as you can see, I'll blow it up a bit. The little bugger went up and stopped me out on the second half. What can you do? So a little bit of money made, no money lost. What more can you ask for? That's been a particularly good run on the old upthrust. And if the trend was up, then I would be trading springs. The beauty of the, when you trade them with the trend, the hit rate is good. But the beauty of it is that if you get in at the right place, the risk is very low in relation to the reward. And the big, big thing about them is that they tend to go quick. You're not sitting in a trade for bloody hours on end waiting for it to move. They tend to go quick or you get stopped out. Okay, very important level, folks. If you're a position trader, as I say, you just need to watch this closing overlap. A couple of closes below that particular high, and I think that we'll visit the June lows, and unfortunately a high probability of taking out the June lows. A bounce here and a push up could lead to a further nice big wave up the page, and that would mean that this is not a corrective wave at all, but this is in fact an impulse wave and the start of a new bullish era for the market. So everything to play for in the next couple of days. I haven't got any positions open at the moment. Nothing in gold, nothing in oil, although I'm looking at both those markets. Again, both the gold market and the crude oil market are sitting at incredibly important support levels. This is not surprising. There's sort of three seasons in the trading year. That the first one is from the first trading day of the new year to Easter. And then we go from Easter to Labor Day, and then Labor Day, that Tuesday, today, right through to Christmas. So the third season is just about to start, and it'll mess around for a day or two, and then I think we'll be rewarded with quite a big trending move one way or the other. Just remember that the VectorVest system will pick that up. And if we go to the 3 month again, our primary wave, which is the shortest measure of the trend, is still down. When it turns, folks, it will pick it up. So it's a totally and utterly objective signal, no head scratching or whatever part of your anatomy you have to scratch to make a decision. It's done for you. As I say, a couple of closes below this horizontal line, and we're going to go much lower indeed. It's always the same at the support level. So folks, I hope that helped. I hope it didn't confuse. Thanks very much. Bye bye.